Okay, good morning. What are the objectives of this video lesson? That means what we discuss in this video lesson, or on completion of this period you would be able to know composition and uses of natural gas and producer gas, the composition and uses of water gas and coal gas, composition and uses of biogas and acetylene gas. Okay, after completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know composition and uses of natural gas and producer gas, the composition and uses of water gas and coal gas, which composition and uses of biogas and acetylene gas. Okay. Composition and uses of gaseous fuels. First we take natural gas. Natural gas, what is the average composition? Okay, which components presents in the natural gas? Methane and ethane. Okay, methane percentage is 70 to 90%, ethane percentage is 5 to 10%. Okay, some more hydrocarbons, very small quantity of hydrocarbons also present, those percentage is 3%. Okay, we are discussing about natural gas. First, what is the composition of natural gas? It contains methane, ethane, small quantity of hydrocarbons. Methane percentage is 70 to 90%, ethane percentage is 5 to 10%, other hydrocarbons percentage is only 3%. Next, what is the calorific value of natural gas? 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube. Next, what is the calorific value? The quantity of heat liberated by the complete combustion of unit weight or volume of the fuel. So what is the definition of calorific value? The quantity of heat, the quantity of heat is liberated by the complete combustion of unit weight or volume of the fuel. So what is the calorific value of natural gas? 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube. Okay, next we discuss uses of natural gas. Okay, it is used as a fuel for domestic and industrial purpose. Okay, natural gas is used in domestic and industrial purpose. Domestic means it is used in our kitchens. This gas is also used in the industries also. Next, a raw material in the synthesis of various chemicals. It is the raw material in the synthesis of various chemicals. It is a source of hydrogen. It is a source of hydrogen. These are the uses of natural gas. Okay, it is used as a fuel for domestic and industrial purpose, a raw material in the synthesis of various chemicals. Next, a source of hydrogen. These are the uses of natural gas. Okay, next we discuss about producer gas. It is the mixture of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and nitrogen, and small quantities of hydrogen and carbon dioxide. Okay, producer gas is a mixture of carbon monoxide, nitrogen and little amount of hydrogen and carbon dioxide. Next, so average composition. A carbon monoxide percentage is 22 to 30%, nitrogen 52 to 55%, hydrogen 8 to 12%, carbon dioxide 3%. This is the average composition of producer gas. Mainly, which gases are present in the producer gas? Carbon monoxide, nitrogen, carbon dioxide. carbon monoxide percentage is 22 to 30%, nitrogen 52 to 55%, H2 8 to 12%, carbon dioxide 3%. Next, calorific value is 1160 to 1420 kilocalories per meter cube. That means what is the calorific value? The amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight of producer gas, unit weight or volume of producer gas. The amount of heat energy is liberated by combustion of unit weight or volume of producer gas. That is a calorific value. So calorific value is 1160 to 1420 kilocalories per meter cube. Next, we discuss uses of producer gas. Okay, it is used for running gas engines. It is used for heating open hearth muffle furnaces. Heating open hearth and muffle furnaces. It is used as a reducing agent in metallurgical operations. Next, it is used as fuel in the steel and glass industry also. It is used in the manufacture of ammonia. These are the uses of producer gas. Listen. It is used for running gas engines. It is used for heating open hearth and muffle furnaces. It is used as reducing agent in metallurgical operations. It is used as fuel in the steel and glass industry. It is used in the manufacture of ammonia also. These are the uses of producer gas. Next, we discuss about water gas. Water gas is a mixture of mainly carbon monoxide and hydrogen with little amount of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Okay, water gas is a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen with little amount of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Next, average composition of water gas. Carbon monoxide is 40 to 50%, hydrogen 45 to 50%, carbon dioxide 4%, nitrogen 3%. Okay, average composition of water gas. Carbon monoxide 40 to 50%, hydrogen 45 to 50%, carbon dioxide 4%, nitrogen 3%. Next, the calorific value. Water gas calorific value, that means the amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of water gas. So what is the calorific value of water gas? 2796 kilocalories per meter cube. 2796 kilocalories per meter cube. This is about the water gas. Okay, next we discuss about the uses of water gas. Water gas uses. It is used as a fuel in industries. It is used in the manufacture of methane and methyl alcohol, etc. Used as illuminant. Okay, it is used as fuel in industries. It is used in the manufacture of methane, methyl alcohol, etc. It is used as illuminant. These are the uses of water gas. Okay, listen. Next, we discuss about coal gas. Coal gas is prepared by the destructive distillation of coal and passing the vapors through water for the removal of tarry material. Okay, coal gas is prepared by the destructive distillation of coal and passing the vapors through water for the removal of tarry material. Next, coal gas is a mixture of hydrogen, methane, carbon monoxide with little amount of nitrogen and carbon dioxide. A coal gas is a mixture of hydrogen, methane, carbon monoxide, nitrogen, carbon dioxide. Next, average composition of coal gas: hydrogen 50%, methane 25 to 35%, carbon monoxide 4 to 10%, nitrogen 1%, carbon dioxide 1%. This is the average composition of coal gas: hydrogen 50%, methane 25 to 35%, carbon monoxide 4 to 10%, nitrogen 1%, carbon dioxide 1%. Next, calorific value: the amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of coal gas. So what is the value? 4895 kilocalories per meter cube. Calorific value of coal gas is 4895 kilocalories per meter cube. This is about the coal gas. Okay, next, uses of coal gas. Okay, it is used as domestic and industrial fuel. It is used as also illuminant. To provide reducing atmosphere in various metallurgical processes. These are the uses. Okay, it is used as domestic and industrial fuel. It is used as illuminant to provide reducing atmosphere in various metallurgical processes. These are the uses of coal gas. Okay, next we discuss about biogas. This is a biogas. Okay, how it is prepared means, gobar gas is an example of biogas. Gobar gas is an example of biogas. Generally, gobar gas is used in the villages. How the biogas is prepared means, biogas is produced by fermentation of cow dung by the bacterial action in the absence of oxygen. Biogas is produced by fermentation of cow dung by the bacterial action in the absence of oxygen. Or biogas is produced by the degradation of any organic waste by bacterial action in the absence of oxygen. Biogas is produced by the degradation of any organic waste by bacterial action in the absence of oxygen. Next, biogas is the mixture of methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, nitrogen. Biogas is the mixture of methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, nitrogen. Next, average composition of biogas: methane 55%, carbon dioxide 35%, hydrogen 7.4%, nitrogen 2.6%. Okay, methane 55%, carbon dioxide 35%, hydrogen 7.4%, nitrogen 2.6%. Okay, what is the calorific value of gobar gas? Calorific value means the amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of biogas. So that value is 5016 kilojoules per meter cube. Biogas calorific value 5016 kilojoules per meter cube. Next, uses of biogas. Biogas is used as domestic fuel for heating and lighting purpose. Biogas is used as domestic fuel for heating and lighting purpose. Heating and lighting purpose. Next, already we have discussed calorific value in kilocalories per meter cube is 1200 to 1300 kilocalories per meter cube. Okay, calorific value: the amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of biogas. is calorific value. That value is 1200 to 1300 kilocalories per meter cube, 5016 kilojoules per meter cube. This is about the biogas. Okay, next we discuss about acetylene gas. Acetylene gas formula is C2H2. It is prepared by the action of water on calcium carbide. Okay, it is prepared by the acetylene gas is prepared by the action of water on the calcium carbide. Calcium carbide means CaC2. It is reacted with water and produce acetylene gas C2H2. This is the chemical reaction. CaC2 plus 2H2O gives C2H2 plus CaOH of 2. So acetylene is prepared by the action of water on the calcium carbide. Next, calorific value, the amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of C2H2 acetylene. That value is 6194 kilocalories per meter cube. Acetylene calorific value is 6194 kilocalories per meter cube. This is about the acetylene gas. Next, we discuss about uses. Acetylene gas uses of acetylene. It is used as in oxyacetylene torch for cutting and welding of metals. It is used as in oxyacetylene torch for cutting and welding of metals. It is used in the manufacture of plastics like PVC. It is used in the manufacture of plastics like PVC. It is used for the preparation of poisonous gases such as Lewisite. Next, it is used in the lighthouse or hawker's lamp for lighting purpose. Generally, lighthouse present in the beaches. Okay, it is used in preparation of acetaldehyde, acetic acid. These are the uses of acetylene gas. Listen, it is used in oxyacetylene torch for cutting and welding of material. So, in the welding, acetylene gas is used. It is used in the manufacture of plastics like PVC, polyvinyl chloride. It is used in the manufacture of plastics like polyvinyl chloride or PVC. Next, it is used for the preparation of poisonous gases such as Lewisite. It is used in the lighthouse and hawker's lamp for lighting purpose. It is used in the preparation of acetaldehyde, acetic acid. These are the uses of acetylene gas. To summarize of which topics we have discussed in this video lesson, we have discussed about composition and uses of natural gas and producer gas. Next, composition and uses of water gas and coal gas. Next, composition and uses of biogas and acetylene gas. These topics we have discussed. Composition and uses of natural gas, producer gas, water gas, coal gas, biogas, and acetylene gas. Okay, next, we discuss some multiple choice questions. Which topics we have discussed in this video lesson? First one, the main composition of natural gas is A, CH4, methane, B, CO plus H2, C, H2 plus CO, CO plus N2. This is producer gas, this is water gas. Natural gas mainly contain methane. So A is the correct answer. The main composition of natural gas is methane. Okay, next question. Natural gas calorific value range is 1160 to 1420 kilocalories per meter cube, not correct. 3000 kilocalories per meter cube, not correct. 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube, this is correct answer. 1200 kilocalories per meter cube, also not correct. So C is the correct answer. The natural gas calorific value range is 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube. Already we have discussed calorific value. The amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of natural gas. Okay, next question. The main composition of producer gas is, A, methane plus carbon monoxide CH4 plus CO, B, CO plus N2, C, H2 plus methane, D, carbon monoxide plus H2. Carbon monoxide plus H2 is water gas. This is not correct. C is not correct. B is the correct answer. Carbon monoxide plus nitrogen. The main composition of producer gas is CO plus N2. B is the correct answer. Okay, next question. Calorific value of producer gas is in range of 1160 to 1420 kilocalories per meter cube, 3000 kilocalories per meter cube, 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube, 1200 kilocalories per meter cube. So 1160 to 1420 kilocalories per meter cube is correct. So what is the calorific value? The amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of producer gas is called calorific value of producer gas. That is, A is the correct answer. 1160 to 1420 A is the correct answer. Okay, next question. The main composition of water gas is CH4, A, B, CO plus H2, C, H2 plus CO, D, CO plus N2. The main composition of water gas is carbon monoxide plus hydrogen. B is the correct answer. The main composition of water gas is CO plus H2. B is the correct answer. Okay, next question. Calorific value of water gas is 1160 to 1420 kilocalories per meter cube. A, B is 2796 kilocalories per meter cube. C is 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube. D is 1200 kilocalories per meter cube. Okay. The calorific value of water gas is 2796 kilocalories per meter cube. This is the correct answer. Calorific value of water gas means the amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of water gas is calorific value of water gas. That is 2796 kilocalories per meter cube. B is the correct answer. Okay, we discuss the next question. The main composition of coal gas is CH4 plus COA, B is CO plus N2, C H2 plus CH4, D CO plus H2. So the main composition of coal gas is H2 plus CH4. C is the correct answer. The main composition of coal gas is H2 plus CH4. C is the correct answer. Okay, next question. Calorific value of coal gas is A, 4895 kilocalories per meter cube, B, 3000 kilocalories per meter cube, C, 8000 to 14000 kilocalories per meter cube, D, 1200 kilocalories per meter cube. The calorific value of coal gas is 4895 kilocalories per meter cube. So what is the calorific value of coal gas? The amount of heat energy is liberated by the combustion of unit weight or volume of coal gas is calorific value of coal gas. That is 4895 kilocalories per meter cube. So A is the correct answer. A is the correct answer. Okay, next question. The cheapest and easily obtained biogas is A, acetylene gas, B, natural gas, C gobar gas, D coal gas. The cheapest and easily obtained biogas is gobar gas. C is the correct answer. Gobar gas is the cheapest and easily obtained biogas. C is the correct answer. Next question. The main composition of biogas. CH4 plus CO2A, B H2 plus CO, C CH4 plus H2, D CO plus H2. The main composition of biogas is methane and carbon dioxide. So A is the correct answer. The main composition of biogas, methane plus CO2, A is the correct answer. Next question. Acetylene gas is used for source of hydrogen. A, B, cutting and welding metals. Gobar gas preparation, reducing atmosphere and metallurgy. Acetylene gas is used for cutting and welding metals. Cutting and welding metals. Next question. The gas obtained by degrading of biological matter. A, coal gasser, B, water gas, C, gobar gas, D, producer gas. The gas obtained by degrading of biological matter is gobar gas. C is the correct answer. Gobar gas is the correct answer. Okay. Some questions are frequently asked in the examination, what we have discussed in the video lesson. First question is, write composition and any two uses of the following: water gas, coal gas. Next, second question, write the composition and any two uses of the following: biogas, acetylene gas. Next question, write the composition, any two uses of the following: producer gas, natural gas. You ask any two gases. Okay, write the composition and any two uses of the following: water gas, coal gas. Write the composition and any two uses of the following: biogas, acetylene gas. Write the composition and any two uses of the following: producer gas, natural gas. Okay, in this video lesson, we discuss another lesson, that is polymers. We discuss about polymers. Okay, what are the objectives of polymers lesson? After completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know. Polymers used in daily life: define polymerization, addition polymerization, examples for addition polymers. Examples for addition polymers. Okay, we see these pictures. Here, plastic pipe is there. These are the water tanks. These are the plastic material, buckets like that, chairs, buckets, stools. Okay, all these are familiar items of plastics. All these are familiar items of plastics. Okay, listen, introduction of polymers. What items we have shown, those are familiar items called plastics. Already we have shown, those are familiar items, those are called plastics. What is the plastic means? Plastic is any material capable of changing its shape. Already know that. Plastic is any material capable of changing its shape. Shape can be changed by applying pressure, water, solvent or heat. Okay. By applying pressure, water, solvents or heat, plastic shape can be changed. Okay, plastic shape can be changed by applying pressure, water, solvents or heat. Plastics are made of polymers. Plastics are made of polymers. This is about the introduction of polymers. Plastic is any material capable of changing its shape. Shape can be changed by applying pressure, water, solvent or heat. Next, plastics are made of polymers. Plastics are made of polymers. Now we discuss about polymers. Polymer is a Greek word which means many units. Polymers is a Greek word. Polymer means many units or large molecules. Polymer is a large molecules made of single units called monomers. Made of single units called monomers. But polymer is a many, contain many units. Polymer is a large molecule. Many monomeric units join to form a polymer. Many monomeric units join to form a polymer. Molecular weight range polymer. Molecular weight range from 5000 to 20,000. 5000 to 20,000. Number of monomeric units in a polymer is called degree of polymerization. Number of monomeric units in a polymer is called degree of polymerization. Okay, listen, what is the polymer means? A high molecular weight compound formed by the reaction of large number of one or more types of small and simple molecules. What is the polymer? A high molecular weight compound formed by the reaction of large number of one or more types of small and simple molecules is called polymer. Simple molecules are called monomers. Polymers are classified as natural and synthetic. Okay, polymer is a Greek word which means many units or large molecules. Made of single units called monomers. Many monomeric units join to form polymer. That means high molecular weight formed by the reaction of large number of monomers or small and simple molecules is called polymer. Molecular weight range polymer, molecular weight range from 5000 to 20,000. Number of monomeric units in a polymer is called degree of polymerization. Polymers are classified as natural synthetic. Next, we discuss about polymers are two types, natural and synthetic. Natural polymers are cellulose, cotton, starch, food grains, proteins, food, skin, hair, silk, rubber, milk from trees. Okay, natural polymers are cellulose. It is obtained from cotton, starch. It is present in the food grains, proteins. It is present in the food, skin, hair, silk, rubber. It is obtained from milk from trees. Next, synthetic polymers are polyesters. Already we know that polyester cloth, that is sterling. Polyamides, that is nylon. Polyvinyls, acrylics, polyvinyl chloride. Polyurethanes, these are the synthetic polymers. Synthetic polymers are polyesters, those are sterling. Polyamides, that is nylon. Polyvinyls, acrylics, PVC, polyurethanes. Okay, next we discuss about polymerization. Okay, monomer is the single unit of polymer. Monomer is the single unit of polymer. Two monomer units join to form a dimer. Three monomer units join to form a trimer. Many monomer units join to form a polymer. Many monomer units join to form a polymer. Okay, more number of monomer units present in a polymer. So what about the polymerization means? Process of joining many monomer units is called polymerization. Process of joining many monomer units is called polymerization. So what is the definition of polymerization means? The reaction, what is the definition of polymerization means? The reaction in which many simple or smaller molecules react to form high molecular weight product is called polymerization. The reaction in which many simple or smaller molecules react to form high molecular weight product is called polymerization. Okay. Monomers are two types. Unsaturated monomers having double or triple bonds. Monomers are two types. Unsaturated monomers having double or triple bonds. Example, ethylene, its formula CH2 double bond, CH2 double bond present. Next, vinyl chloride, CH2 double bond, CHCl. These are the unsaturated monomers. Next, functional monomers have groups that are highly reactive. Functional monomers have groups that are highly reactive. Second, adipic acid, COOH, CH2O4, COOH, these are the groups. COOHs are groups. Ethylene glycol, OH, CH2, CH2, OH, OH is the group. Urea, NH2, CO, NH2, NH2 is the group. So, functional monomers have groups that are highly reactive. This is about the monomers. Okay, next we discuss about types of polymerization. First, what is the polymerization? Already we have discussed the reaction in which many simple and smaller molecules react to form a high molecular weight product is called polymerization. The reaction in which many simple and smaller molecules react to form a high molecular weight product is called polymerization. The product formed in polymerization is called polymer, and the smaller reactive molecules are called monomers. Which small molecules are participated in polymerization? Those are monomers. Which product is formed in the polymerization? That is polymer. Okay. Generally, monomers are simple unsaturated molecules. Polymerization takes place between monomers of same type or different types. Polymerization takes place between monomers of same type or different types. The monomers combine in different way, resulting the formation of a polymer having linear or branched or three-dimensional structure. Next, we discussed about types of polymerization. A polymerization is a reaction in which many simple and smaller molecules combine to form high molecular weight product. Okay, the polymerization reactions are two types. One is addition polymerization, another one is condensation polymerization. Okay, one is addition polymerization, another one is condensation polymerization. Okay, next we discuss about one by one. Okay, next first we discuss about addition polymerization. What about the addition polymerization means? The polymerization in which monomers add together to form high molecular weight product is called addition polymerization. It is also called as chain polymerization. The polymerization in which monomers add together to form a high molecular weight product is called addition polymerization. It is also called as chain polymerization. Okay, in this polymerization, unsaturated monomers are participated. No atom or molecule is eliminated in this process. It is triggered by catalyst, heat, light, pressure. Degree of polymerization is also high. Yields high molecular weight polymers. Reaction is very fast. So, what is the addition polymerization? The polymerization in which monomers add together to form high molecular weight product without elimination of molecules is called addition polymerization. It is also called as chain polymerization. In this polymerization, unsaturated monomers are participated. No atom or molecule is eliminated in the addition polymerization. It is triggered by catalyst, heat, light, pressure. Degree of polymerization is high, that means many number of monomers are participated. Yields high molecular weight polymers. Reaction is very fast. We discuss one example. Polyethylene is formed by addition polymerization of ethylene under high pressure and temperature. Okay, which monomer is participated in the preparation of polyethylene? Ethylene is participated. This is the monomer. Ethylene monomer is CH2 double bond CH2 molecules combined, that is dimer. 3 CH2 molecules combined, that is trimer. Many number of CH2 molecules combined, that is polymer. So this ethylene monomers are participated in addition polymerization under high pressure and temperature and form polyethylene. This is the polyethylene. But this is about the example of addition polymerization. Polyethylene is formed by addition polymerization of ethylene under high pressure and temperature. We take another example addition polymerization. Polyvinyl chloride is formed by addition polymerization of vinyl chloride in presence of a catalyst. Vinyl chloride monomers combine together by participating addition polymerization and form polyvinyl chloride. Okay, we take monomer of vinyl chloride CH2 double bond CHCl. This is one unit. Two units combined, that is dimer. Many number of units combined, that is polymer, that is called polyvinyl chloride. This polyvinyl chloride is formed by the addition polymerization of vinyl chloride in presence of catalyst. Okay, next, homo and copolymers. Homopolymer. Polymers with the same kind of monomer units, that is example of polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, that is called homopolymer. Okay, in the preparation of polyethylene, only ethylene monomers are participated. In the preparation of polyvinyl chloride, only vinyl chloride monomers are participated. So this type of polymers are called homopolymers. Copolymers, polymers made from two or more kinds of monomers, that is polyethylene co-vinyl acetate, polyacrylonitrile co-styrene co-butadiene. That means in the preparation of polymers, different kinds of monomers are participated. That polymer is called copolymer. In the preparation of polymers, same type of monomers are participated. That is called homopolymer. Okay, next summarize of this lesson in the video lesson. Okay, most of the products we use daily are plastics and they are polymers. Polymers are made of small units called monomers. Polymerization is joining of monomers. Degree of polymerization is the number of monomer units. Unsaturated monomers contain double bonds. Functional monomers contain reactive groups. Okay, what we have discussed of this lesson in the video lesson. Most of the products we use daily are plastics and they are polymers. Polymers are made of small units called monomers. Polymerization is joining of monomers. Degree of polymerization is the number of monomer units. Unsaturated monomers contain double bonds. Functional monomers contain reactive groups. Okay, next. Addition polymerization joins saturated monomer, unsaturated monomers. Addition polymerization joins unsaturated monomers. No molecules are removed. Fast process, high molecular weight polymers. Polyethylene, PVC are example of addition polymers. Homopolymer contains same kind of monomer units. Copolymer contain two or three kinds of monomer units. Okay, addition polymerization. In the addition polymerization, unsaturated monomers are participated. No molecules are removed. This is the fast process. High molecular weight polymer is obtained. Polyethylene, PVC are examples of addition polymerization. Homopolymer contains same kind of monomer units. Copolymer contains two or three kinds of monomer units. Okay, thank you for listening of this video lesson.